teaching. If you stop working there, you stop doing the work there, you make the struggle, you stop the ways, whatever the jo bhi tarike, whatever the ways we have the struggle, definitely we'll get the thing there. Otherwise we can't. So the only problem is this, that what we actually want. This has to be seen by we people here. We are lawyers. If we are only lawyers and thinking that we can do many things for the street vendor, then very sorry to say, friends, it is injustice to the vendors. It is injustice to every poor people of this country. Because don't think that you are only a lawyer. First you think you are a human rights activist. If you are human rights activist, you would think that the scenario can be.
Nobody treats them as missions. Now the problem in our country is tremendous corruption in all municipalities, by whatever name they are called in different parts of the municipality, or the authority, statutory authority, who is supposed to regulate what they would call problems or menace of street vendors. There is a unholy nexus with the police, because the municipalities will harass you till you bribe them, and if someone else bribes them more, they will go in their favor. Police has their own percentage depending on the area and place and how much money poor vendor is going to make per day, so they have their own percentage. The third enemy of municipal authorities, police, the third enemy is the shop owners. They consider street vendors as their competitors. They say that I spend so much of rent or I buy this shop. But if you can't afford, we'll give you something in somewhere else. If you even can't afford that, we'll give you something on the outskirts of the village. Everything, corruption is totally and completely, it is legalized, regularized, and it goes on under the nose of everyone. Now, I am not ready to believe that this money which is collected from the street vendors stops at the inspector of MCD or NDMC, or it stops at the police constable who is supposed to go around. Nor am I ready to believe that it will stop at commissioner of police or commissioner of corporations. It has to go to the political masters. It's the political masters who has the power. It's the political master who will issue notification. It's the political master who will declare this street as no vendor zone. It is the political masters who use them during election. In fact, election time is the time when all street vendors become VIPs. You know, they are all political parties. You know, my dear chair, elect me. Once you elect me, I will see that next time you will. I'll solve all your problems. And that is like all election promises made by all parties, and I'm not saying that any particular party is good or bad. They are equally bad. They all make promises and say, oh, once election is over, what can I do? I want to do, but look at this. Other problem the street vendors face.
We can't. Because they are not coming, because you are anticipated.